Lasius flavus is a unique species which has yellow queens and workers. This species is interesting because the queens are oligyny, which means that the workers will tolerate multiple queens. Welcome to a new Lasius flavus colony update. In this update, I will talk about my two Lasius flavus colonies. This will be an interesting video, so watch until the end for some nice bonus footage. Also, while you are here, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Alright, apparently it has been 9 months ago since I last did a Lasius flavus update. The reason for the delay is because not much is happening with the colony. This is partially my fault, but more on that later. As the thumbnail implies, the colony is missing a lot of brood. To understand why, let me first tell you a little bit about the past 9 months with this colony. I got 3 Lasius flavus queens in the summer of 2020. They look beautiful and I fell in love with them very quickly. It wasn't too long before the first workers emerged. Everything seemed to be going quite well for them. I kept one queen in a test tube and merged two together. The two queen colonies quickly became the main event, and I attached them to a Kusi Generation 1 feeding module. This module seemed great at the time, but it was weird. Every time I looked at the colony, I saw less workers. But there were no dead workers in the outworld. This confused me, and I started to pay closer attention to the colony. It took me several months after hibernation to find out that the ants could actually escape the feeding module. This combined with the casual drowning Lasius flavus does in liquid food, made the colony numbers drop instead of climb. Meanwhile, my test tube colony queen only grew in numbers, despite having only one queen. But also, they drowned in ant sugar often, so their numbers did not spike as well. But yay, maybe do something about the feeding. You are absolutely right. At the time, I just thought I was unlucky. Later, I found out that this happens a lot with smaller species. That's why I now feed small colonies by putting some ant nectar on a cotton ball and providing it to them that way. This brings the chance of your colony drowning to 0%. Like I say in most of my videos, I am a beginner ant keeper. Look at my first video. That's the date I started to take ant keeping seriously. So yeah, I make plenty of mistakes. But by showing them to you, it might prevent you from making them. I connected the two queen colony to my own outworld module. I really hate to say this in a video, but apparently Lasius flavus can escape these modules as well. I found out pretty late after a few customers reported the same issue. I took this feedback to heart and quickly changed the design of the outworld plates. Now even Solenopsis fugax can't crawl through the gaps. The mini outworld has been working great for them so far, and I'm quite happy how they are doing ever since. Off camera, I moved the colony to another test tube. This test tube is special since it has inserts in them, or ringserts as I like to call them. These ringserts are a new product on my Etsy store. Link is in the description if you are interested. For a species like Lasius flavus, these ringserts are great. A classic mistake I made is placing a ringsert against the cotton. It fell in there and I was too lazy to take it out. At first I thought it was great, but the colony is trying to dig behind it, which of course I don't want. As of now, I don't see it as a huge problem, and before it becomes a problem, the water will probably run out anyway. I hope that this colony can reach 100 workers before the end of the year, but I doubt it. I really want to move them into a nest, but with Lasius flavus in particular, it's better to wait until they have a lot of workers. The next update on them will probably be next year. I'll make sure to show them to you once in a while. Last thing I did was attach the test tube with a single queen to my mini outworld. It was a little bit of a struggle since the test tube size is different. But with some cotton and tubing, I fixed it quite fast. I attached a fresh tube with insert, which the ants will hopefully move into soon. I will also darken that test tube with a test tube cover. These covers are also available on my shop, link in bio. Honestly, these are the greatest things I ever printed. As you can see, all my colonies have one now. And that brings us to the end of this video. Like I said, this colony will slowly grow and get featured only a few times a year. Lasius flavus in my case is a slow growing species, but a beautiful one. This summer I will definitely catch a lot of new Lasius flavus queens, but I will probably not keep them. Hopefully in the next video I can show you the ants in one of my 3D printed ant nests. Do you have a suggestion where to put them in? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching this video. I see you in the next one.